저희 퀸튜브에 강의 영상을 올렸는데 어떤
Where's injured Meyer?
I think he's playing another game.
Alright.
한 분께서 12 한마당에
I'm gonna link that guy your stream.
부진 투게이트.
2게이트. So this situation explained 12 natural 12 hatch and then dealing with 10 12.
투게이트 운영을 하면은 어떤 식으로 대처를 해야 하나요? 라고
How do you deal with it?
이거를 when you do 12 hatch. 알려드리려고 하거든요. 테라님께서 궁금해하신 플레이 알려드리도록 하겠습니다. 12합을 할 거면은 일단 오버로드를 대각선 쪽으로
If you're doing 12 hatch, you have to put your overload to the cross position. Send your first overload to cross position.
내 앞마당으로 프로브가 오는지
If you're running 12 hatch? Oh, so he's going 12 hatch this game.
Yes, yes.
Oh, shit. That's weird. Did he talk about why he decided to do 12 hatch?
I don't know.
You
have to, what you have to watch out with the Overlord is, you have to see what timing of the Proto Scout. Like, when, if it's the Scout of his, the Pylon Scout, like, what time it comes in.
왜냐면은 파일런 서치가
Because 파일런 서치
첫 서치를 왔다. 그러면은 오버풀을 해 주시는 게 좋아요.
Because if the Protoss first scouts you with the pylon search, it's way much better for you to do overpull build rather than 12 patch.
12합을 하려고 하다가 여기 앞마당에 파일런 견제 당하고 파일런 견제를 안 당해도 상대 프로토스도 그거를 보고 넥서스 포지 이런 식으로 가게 되면은
So the situation where you want to avoid going hatch first is when they first scout you because they can do pylon harass to delay your natural. They can also do nexus first into forge, which is much more greedy counter build and a more economic build for Protoss.
네, 오버풀 가주시는 게 좋습니다.
So it's much better to go overpull if you have if the Protoss first scouts you as a pylon search.
그리고 오버로드 꺾는 타이밍은 오버풀 타이밍.
So you change so you don't see the probe right now, right? So the timing to change direction with your overlord is at the overpull timing.
오버로드를 찍고 미네랄 한 150원 정도 때 프로브가 오거든요.
So this is around the time where the probe with the pylon search would come when your mineral is around 150 and you have made an overlord. So that's the timing where first scout pylon search would come.
지금쯤 안 오면은
If the probe does not come right now, it's not a pylon search.
안 온다는 소리예요. 그러면
pylon scout.
Alright, that's pretty useful actually. It's really
Then you change the direction.
정찰원은 타이밍을 보고도 대충 예상을 할 수가 있는데
You can predict how the Protoss opens by looking at the probe scouting timing.
초보분들은 그거를 다 구별하기가 힘들어요.
For noobs, it might be hard for you to distinguish between the scout timing.
때문에 정찰을 가주시면 됩니다. 언제 앞마당으로 가면서 앞마당.
So for noobs, it might be more beneficial for you to scout instead. So you're gonna scout with your drone dealt when you're about to make your hatchet natural.
하러 가면서 하나는 앞마당 짓고 하나는 정찰을 가시면 돼요.
So one drone makes
위치는 자유고.
Natural expansion while your other drone goes to scout and your first overlord scout go wherever.
오버로드가 5시로 드론이 11시로 가셔도 돼요.
It's fine for the drone to go to 11 o'clock or to 5 o'clock.
여기서 드론을 찍어주지 않고 바로 스포닝풀을 지어주면 되겠습니다.
From here, you don't get drone right away with that larva. You make a spawning pool first.
아, 스포닝 풀을 바로 지어야 돼요.
You must make spawning pool right away.
대기하고 있다가 이렇게 200원 되자마자 바로.
So have your drone ready to make spawning pool right away at 200 minerals.
미네랄 200원 되고 스포닝 풀 지어야지. 이러면은 첫 찔러에 피해를 입을 수가 있기 때문에.
If you don't do this, you delay your Spawning pool even a little bit, you might be taking some damage from the first sellout 타이밍.
스포닝 풀 타이밍도 최대한 빠르게.
So you must get the spawning pool as fast as possible.
본진까지 들어가 줘야겠죠.
We have to scout all the way.
본진 12게이트까지 생각을 하는 거기 때문에.
You have to scout all the way in into the opponent. All the way to their minerals because it might be main one base 10-12.
본진까지 들어가 주시고 Proxy. 드론이 하나 더 나가요. 멀티를 하러. 자, 이 멀티를 하러 나가는데 저 그 정찰관 드론으로 포지 더블 넥서스가 아니다. 뭐 본진 플레이다 하면은 요거를 멀티 정찰관 드론으로 포지 더블 넥서스가 아니다. 뭐 본진 플레이다 하면은 요거를 멀티를 안 해주셔도 돼요. 그리고 미나를 200원 정도 때 스포닝 풀 타이밍도 최대한 빠르게 해주셔야 되고. 자, 본진까지 들어가 줘야겠죠. 본진 10, 12게이트까지 생각을 하는 거기 때문에 본진까지 들어가 주시고.
You can't roll out 10, 12 gate. They might build in their main base too. So just scout all the way into their base.
하나 더 나가요. 멀티를 하러. 자, 이 멀티를
하러. So one more drone goes out to take your another expansion right now.
하러 나가는데.
But while you're scouting, while your expansion drone is going out, if you scout that the Protoss is not going fast expand, but rather doing a one base build, you don't have to expand with it.
저 그 정찰관 드론으로 포지 더블 넥서스가 아니다, 뭐 본진 플레이다 하면은 요거를 멀티를 안 해주셔도 돼요. 그리고 미네랄 200원 정도 때 가스.
At 200 minerals, get mineral gas.
3에 타는 빌드예요. 일단 기본.
So this build overall goes 3 hatch. I mean, gas and then 3rd hatch.
그러. 근데 질롯이 보이네요.
But you see a Zell at this timing.
자, 앞마당에 게이트도 아니에요.
So you don't see any gateway in the front.
그럼 오버로드를 일단 7시 쪽으로 보내주고.
So overlord start going to the 7 o'clock and.
자, 이 그 멀티를 지우려고 왔던 드론은 그냥 앞마당 쪽으로 오시면 됩니다.
So just pull back the drone that you're about to make your third on to your natural.
앞마당에 3인처리를 지워주시면 되고.
And then make your third hatchery at your natural expansion.
자, 지금은 대강성인데.
So this is cross position.
솔직히 멀티를 지워도 되긴 해요. 하지만.
I mean, to be perfectly honest, against a cross positioned Protoss, you can get away with making a expo. Third expo, but
안전하게.
But you're just playing safe right now.
이렇게 지워주시고.
So make your third hatchery and your natural.
안 지워도 막을 수가 있거든요.
So and also since this is a cross position, you can block this without making a sunken.
역전이면 무조건 sunken을 지우셔야 되고.
But in close positions, you must always make a sunken.
옆자리까지 생각을 해서 상품을 짓도록 하겠습니다.
So we're just gonna say it's a near position and then make a sunken.
자, 이 저글링이 뜨면은 상대는 원질럿이에요. 이때 이 타이밍이 원질럿이기 때문에
At this time, it's only gonna be one Zella timing, so
싸워도 이기는데 3질럿 타이밍.
And we were able to win with this horse, but then you have to watch out for the 3 Zella timing.
3질럿 타이밍은 또 12 저글링이 뜨죠?
At the 3 Zella timing, you should be able to get 12 저글링 by now.
12 저글링이 뜨고 여기서 추에 처리해서 레어를 가주세요.
And from here you can go to hatchery into layer.
토큰을 지어주면 좋은 점이 드론을 찍으실 수 있어요.
What's good about making sunken colony in this case is that while you're doing all this, you can also drone up a little bit. You can get away with little droning.
오질럿이 오고 있는데도 오질럿한테 저글링 한 부대면은 지지만 원성큰이 있다면 이길 수가 있어요.
So even though the 5th Zella is gonna come, you should be able to win against 5 Zellas with 12 links and a sunken. You will not be able to win with just 12 links alone, but with sunken you'll be able to win against it.
그렇기 때문에 성큰을 지어주시는 게 되게 안전하고.
Because of that, it's really safe to build a sunken.
레어를 가는 이유는 상대방이 어떤 빌드를 해도 맞춰갈 수 있고 초보분들은 이게 더 편해요.
So this build is kind of for noobs, but what's really good about 2 hatch layer is that you can just match anything Protoss does on that one base. the 10-12 opener safely, no matter what they try to do.
완성...
The 2 hatch Muta is always like comfortable against this type of builds.
내고 오버로드가 나오면 드론을 찍어주면 됩니다.
And then after your overlord comes out there, you can drone up.
APM이 좀 빠르신 분들은 여기서 자블링이 아까 성큰 완성되는 타이밍에 정찰을 가셔가지고.
If your APM can handle this when your 성큰 colony goes up, you can go scout with your links.
앞마당을 짓는지 아니면은 아직도 본진 플레이인지 본진.
So what you need to check here is if the Protoss is continuing to stay on one base or that he expanded.
플레이하면서 가스 짓고 테크 올리는 경우가 있거든요.
There are times when Protoss goes 10-12 gate into gas into tech.
그런 플레이인지 봐주시면 되는데.
So you have to differentiate between those.
오버로드로 보셔도 돼요. 아까 바로.
But you can also see with the overlord as well.
오버로드가 벌써 도착했습니다. 자, 질러 꾸준히 찍으면서 안마당이에요.
So in this case, he had expanded with while getting all these cell up production.
때 뭐 스파이어 올려주시고.
So you can get spire.
상대 빌드가 뭐든지 그냥 스파이어를 올리시면 돼요.
So it doesn't really matter what the opponent do at this point. You can just get spire up now.
오버로드 안 막히게 오버로드 생산해주시고.
Keep making overlords.
저글링 바로 또 되거든요. 근데 여기서 토스 입장을 딱 보면
링 스피드 is gonna be finished soon and then, when I'm gonna go on Protoss's perspective now.
봐주시면 아는데 상대 토스는 저그 진영이 깜깜해요.
So Protoss has no information on what Zerg is doing right now. Absolutely no idea.
가스를 빼고 올 저글링 하는지.
So he does not even know if per se if I took off the drones off the gas and went all link.
아니면은 지금처럼 뮤탈리스크를 가는지
or if you had went lurker or mutalist nothing or
expanded. 굉장히 답답한 상황이고
it's a very uncomfortable position for the Protoss. So right now the tech timing is very gap is very large with you already having a spire while their stargate is just going up.
여기서 상대가 더블 넥서스잖아요. 무조건 뮤탈을 찍을 거예요.
So since the opponent have expanded like this, he's gonna just go always gonna go Muta in this case.
무사를 찍을 건데 여기서 성큰이 중요합니다. 상대가 질러 숫자 세 보세요.
So what you need to do here is focus on the zealot count. You have to count how many zealot they have, and then determine what to do about your sunken count, sunken colony count.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 질럿이에요.
In this case, he has 9
질럿. 찍었다는 소린데.
It means that he has continuously made
zealots. 그러면 질럿이 갑자기 튀어나올 수도 있거든요.
So this might signify that he might be going for a push at any time. So you must be ready for it.
자, 그 튀어나온 질럿을 잡아먹을 것인지 아니면 성큰을 추가로 한 두세 개 정도 더 찍.
So you have to make a decision here. Do you want to overwhelm him with link counts and eat surround his zealot army up when it comes out, or do you wanna just be safe and build two or so more sunkens?
어? 본진으로 달려버릴 것인지 이거는 본인 스타일에 맞춰서 해주시면 돼요.
Or you can just do link run by.
오뮤탈 이후에 스컬지 찍으면 됩니다.
It's all in your type of play, and in this case, it's gonna go 5 Mutas and then Scourge.
오뮤탈 찍냐면은
Why 5 Mutas?
상대 프로브가 한 방이에요. One
because you can one hit probes with 5 Mutalisks.
5, 9, 45. 프로브 체력은 45라서 오뮤탈이 한 방 톡 치면은 프로브가 죽거든요. 그리고 오뮤탈을 찍어주는 거고 일단은 본진으로 뜰 거예요.
Well, and then all the Mutalisks, the 5 Mutalisks will first go into the Protoss main.
저글링 오더는 상대 질럿이 나오는지.
And your link should be constant on lookout for the zealot
movement. 스컬지 찍어주시고 한 4 스컬지.
And make around 4 Scourge after the Mutalisks.
스컬지 정도 찍고 그 다음에는
And then go Hydralisk then.
그리고 이제 랠리 포인트를 앞마당 쪽으로
and then change your rally to your natural and then make some and then things grown up now and you see that the Zealots are starting to come out.
상대도 무탈을 봤기 때문에 급해서 나오는 거예요.
So in this situation, the Protoss is a bit desperate in a situation because the, he had seen the Mutalisk. So the Zealots are coming out a bit of a panic right now.
자, 뮤탈이 안 돌아올 거면은 아까 말했듯이
성... And if the Mutalisk aren't gonna come back to defend, you can just make extra sunkens.
을 추가로 지어주시고 저글링을 찍어서 막던지.
And you can also defend this using links as well, producing links as well.
이렇게 해주시면 되거든요. 자, 뮤탈은 캐논 1.4를 이렇게 해주시고
Their Mutalisk should be focusing on the cannon first.
스컬지는 커세요.
And the Scourge is on Corsair.
히드라 소급 찍고 스컬지 이거
Get Hydra speed.
달려요.
And get more skirt and replenish your skirt count.
피해를 주시면서 하면 되고.
And then you can do some economic damage on the Protoss right now while defending.
막힐 것 같으면은 바로 빼가지고.
And if you feel like your meter count is gonna fall, count is gonna fall down at any point, you should pull back.
저 질럿을 잡아주시면 되겠습니다.
He's gonna be able to defend against Hydra.
이제는 히드라를 찍을 거예요.
And then from now on, you're gonna pump out Hydras. Hydras.
빵. 요 질럿만 잡아 먹어주면은 상대 토스도 지금 아둔이 없어요. 방금 보셨다시피 아둔이 없기 때문에 후속 뭐 다른 거 그 다음 테크가 전혀 없거든요.
So since this Protoss has no tech at all, no Adun. Nothing. You saw that with your Mutalisk. This after you are able to block this push, Protoss has no, you know, end game. You know. So after you block this, you should be in a good position.
질럿만 잡아먹어주면은 토스도 커세어밖에 안 남아요.
The only thing left for you to deal with after dealing with the Zealot push is Corsairs.
저걸링 좀 돌려주면서 살살살살 돌려주면서
just.
커세어도 지금 온다니.
Turn, just turn your Zerglings around and then buy time and get some hits in with your Mutalisk.
예, 안 모여 있어요. 커세어가 몇 마리 안 모여 있어서 요 스컬지에 잡히면은 토스가 손해예요.
So right now, since Protoss doesn't have enough skirt, Corsair count to even deal with this, deal with the scourges. If whenever you can trade against. If the Corsairs come out and they trade, it's a really good trade for you. So, so the Scourges should, so the Corsairs should not be able to advance from their his own base.
잡아먹었으면은,
and after you defend from this attack,
그때부터 히드라 전환.
And then go, you transition completely into Hydra and then get the Hydra range.
이제 히드라를 압박을 가도 되겠죠.
And then now you have some time to put pressure with Hydras.
왜? 아까 말했다시피 토스는 커세어밖에 없으니까.
Why? Because Protoss only has Corsairs right now.
이제?
Remember no tech.
이제 아둔이 올라가고 아둔을 올려도 이 캐논 짓고 나서 지었을 거기 때문에.
Okay, so this is about the time that Adun goes up, and then even then it should be only up after remaking cannons. So. 네.
템플 아카이브가 방금 완성됐어요. 자, 그럼.
Oh, you know, he misjudged it. Temple Archive is just done now.
그러면 5회 처리 늘려주.
Then you go into 5 hatchery.
주시고.
Since Temple Archive is done.
테마크가 완성됐으면은 다크가 나오거든요.
So since the Temple Archive is done, it means that DTs are gonna come out soon. So.
다크가 나오면, 이걸 뚫지를 못할 거예요.
And you won't be able to break, bust this if the DTs come out.
이거 뭐 그래도 뽑아놨으니까 한번.
But since you already made these amount of Hydra, you might as well try to bust.
압박 좋고.
Never mind.
오케이, 좋고요. 자, 3시 지역에 이제 다크가 올 수도 있죠.
So there's a possibility that DTs might be going to the 3 o'clock base.
자, 그 다크를 막아주시면 되겠습니다.
Defend against DTs.
이제 드론을 쬐주면서 챔버.
drawn up and get chamber.
Coseo랑 다크 견제가 올 거예요.
And pretty soon, DT Corsair should be putting pressure on you.
자, 저글링은 시야고 어떻게 해주시고.
Your link should be going out to get vision.
자, 코세오 견제가 왔죠.
And Corsair came to harass, right? You should be focusing on defending this.
계속 이제 드론 쬐는 타이밍이에요.
And this is the timing where you should be droning up.
코스가 방금 캐논이 굉장히 많았죠. 근데 게이트가 아직도 두 개예요.
Okay, so the key point of this droning up phase is because while the Protoss had enormous amount of cannons in the front, he had not much gateways up.
게이트가 두 개이기 때문에 지금 딱 쬐는 겁니다, 적어도.
Since Protoss is only on two gates, this is the right timing to just drone up a lot.
지금이 쬐는 타이밍이에요. 코세오밖에 없어요. 코세오밖에 없고.
Since the only real threat right now is Corsairs, the ground army is not gonna be a threat.
프로토스는 이제 템플러를 슬슬 뽑으면서 템플러 만화를 모으고 있는 타이밍.
And this is the timing. This is the timing where the Protoss should be pumping out Templars and then saving up mana.
그에 반해서 저거는 해처리 뚝뚝 늘어나고 럴커업도 찍었고.
So in response, the Zerg should just hatch up, drone up, get lurker upgrade.
육해 처리를 짓고 이제 히드라 생산을 해주시면 돼요.
Get up to 6 hatcheries and then pump out Hydralis.
가스 보유량도 되게 많아요. 가스 보유량이 많아서.
And you have a lot of gas banked.
자, 퍼세어가 좀 계속 죽어준다? 싶으면은 그때 역류탈을 찍으셔도 되고요.
So at any time, at any point in time, with this amount of gas banked, you can, if per se they throw away their corsairs, overextending any time like that, you can always threaten with Muta Switch.
아니면 럴커가 무난합니다. 럴커.
Or you can also go lurker.
안전한 선택이에요.
But lurker is the safer choice.
지금 여기서 가스가 많기 때문에 3가스는 아직 안 지어도 되고.
Since you have a lot of gas right now, you don't have to build third gas.
7회 처리를 멀티에 푸시면 됩니다.
And then your 7th hatchery should go up on your other expansion.
이게 딱 이제 여기서부터 똑같아요, 운영이.
And from now, the macro game should be exactly the same as other games.
이제 완전 똑같은 운영이고 뭐 일반적인 5회 처리 히드라 운영이라고 볼 수 있어요, 이제.
So, I mean, from here you can kind of say that this is just like going from 5 hatch Hydra to late game phase. Later game phase, just macro.
7회 처리 지어만 주고
get your 7th hatchery.
여기서는 이제 드론을 쬐시면 안 되고 병력을 뽑아 주셔야 됩니다.
And then from here is a timing where you should be pumping out army units rather than droning up.
이거 못 지어도 상관없어요.
It doesn't matter if you are unable to build this.
견제를 당해도 뭐 어쩔 수 없는 겁니다. 상관없고.
It just happens, man. Shit happens.
왜 상관이 없냐? 상대도 아직 멀티가 없어요.
Because the Protoss does not have their third expansion out yet either. It doesn't really matter if you're not able to get the fourth expansion. I mean, the seventh hatchery up.
상대도 멀티 없이 견제만 하는 거라.
So since the Protoss is like harassing without any backup expansion, it's perfectly fine for you to not be able to get your expos up any further.
Yeah. 이거는 뭐 해야 됩니까?
오! 김보즈 데스네.
계속 히드라. 계속 히드라 하면서 이제 럴커업 됐으면 럴커 많이 나오죠?
So now it's their time to get if after your lurkers upgrades are done, it's time to get lurkers. And you should be able to get a bunch because you have saved up gas.
해야 돼요.
What did he say? Fuck.
거 많이 나오죠? 드론은 한 번씩 채우셔야 돼요.
So you need to get one control group of drone at each base mining minerals.
멀티하러 가겠습니다.
Go expand.
상황이 원래 이렇게 유리할 수밖에 없어요.
So in situations like this, there is like no real other way but to be really in good position at this point in time.
그래서 포스도 이런 빌드를 잘 안 하는 거거든요.
That is why no Protosses go 10-12 nowadays.
자, 이 박스 딱 죽여주고 아직 포시 공업도 안 됐어요.
Yeah, and then you can, as you can see, he doesn't even have plus one weapons yet. This is late in the game.
포시 공업도 안 됐고 이제 나
plus 2.
Oh yeah. Oh wait, what did he say? 공이 up or 공이 up?
I don't know, but he had plus one up.
Okay, so
then
plus two.
Then. But it's really late for plus
yeah.
two.
Okay, yeah.
아직 포시 공업도 안 됐어요.
No, he doesn't have plus one.
He just got it then.
He just got it then. It's really late then. Yeah, so in this timing, since it's 10-12, there's no way that this Protoss was able to get all that and then also Observer, so...
그러면 뭘 해야 될까요?
So what do you do now? Stop Lurkers.
한번 가도록 하겠습니다.
So you can afford to get away with Stop Lurker now.
럴커 다 박아놨고 스탑 럴커 움직이 해놔요.
Do some stop lurker. Sit at bait.
온다.
It's coming.
온다. 자 이거 템플러까지 잡아먹어야 됩니다. 템플러.
Okay, so when you're doing the stop lurker, important thing, you have to get the templars.
온다.
Focus on the templars.
안 온다.
Oh, never mind. He's not coming yet. After all.
이쪽으로 오나요? 근데 여기도
He's coming this way,
있기 때문에.
But he has lurkers here as well.
자, 어디 쪽으로 오든 럴커가 있기 때문에
No matter where the Protoss turns, there's always gonna be lurkers there.
안심하셔도 되고요.
So you're pretty safe. You
자,
can be assured.
템플러가 오면은 긁어줍니다.
When the Templars come, focus fire on the Templars.
고찰이죠?
Yeah.
야, 좋아요.
You're in a really good position now. So get your lurkers on the road and then go attack. See, it's really clean now. It's a really clean engagement for you. And then get plus 2 weapons on Hydralisks, ranged upgrade. Keep going, keep pumping on Hydras now. So the order of the upgrades are plus 2 range and then get the Carapace upgrade. Oh, he's trying to break this.
What?
Yeah, so plus 2 Carapace and then into Hive. So when your hatchery gets that low, it's just good to get layer off it.
변태를 하세요. 근데 레어 변태 할 때는 체력이 안 차요. 그래서 공격 다 막고 레어 변태 하셔야 돼요.
So another tip, when you're trying to heal the hatchery by morphing into layer, you have to, it won't regenerate while it's morphing. So you have to block any sort of, you know, attack pass. While it's morphing, so that's another tip.
레어가 되면은 체력이 좀 차는데 변태하는 중간에는 피가 안 차니까.
Yeah, it does. The HP does not regen while it's morphing into layer.
처음에 세실 처리 질럿이 점프해서 깼으면요. 근데 그거는
ask the Zerg biologist.
동실력일 때 그런 상황이 잘 안 나와요.
So in this case. When you have all these explosives up and you're in the same skill level as the opponent, it normally doesn't get into this situation, but
그러니까 딱 그 해보면은 해처리가 깨졌다? 그러면은 내가 그냥 못하는 거 뭐 제가
I mean, so if by any chance Protoss was able to get that third hatchery with those 9 zealots at the start of the game, it just means you're suck, okay? You're outskilled. It just, yeah, that's all it means.
해처리가 깨질 정도였으면 뮤탈을 안 뺐을 거예요. 왜?
So and also if the hatchery were to go down, he wouldn't have pulled back those mirrors. Why? Because?
뮤탈로 게임을 끝낼만 했으니까.
Because in that situation, was a good enough situation for you to end the game right away, right out there, with even while sacking your third.
그러면은 3시가 깨져도 상관이 없어요.
I mean, if you end the game right there with those mutalists, the game's over. So there's no need to pay attention to that third hatch. But in this case,
뮤탈리스크를 뺄 거냐, 아니면 공격을 할 거냐 선택을 하는 거기 때문에. 그거를 보고 하는 거거든요.
So the what your decision making comes into play in this situation in the early game where if you're going to pull back your middleless and try to defend or you try to win the game outright while sacking your third. This is where decision making skill comes in.
토스도 아니 본진에 오뮤탈이 왔어요. 본진에 오뮤탈이 왔는데
to think of it on the Protoss side a perspective. So you're playing one base build, and five mutas came into your base.
아니, 멀티만 깨러 갈 거예요? 무조건.
So what are you gonna do? Are you gonna just sit there and then just break the expansion, or?
안 마당으로 와요.
Or are you just gonna go to the natural? Of course, you're just gonna shove into the natural. If the Protoss, as a Protoss, you're getting harassed as mutas, on one base.
무조건 안 마당으로 오는데. 그거를 이제 저그도 보고 뮤탈로 보고 아 이건 죽일 수 있겠다 하면은 3시 정도는 버리고 앞마당에만 성근을 짓고 막아주는 거죠.
So, okay, another commentary. So, reason why he didn't build sunkens on the third, but just a natural, was because in that case, it was all about decision making. While being able to see from both perspectives, like Protoss has 5 mutas on his base, the Protoss has to just end the game if you are not to pull back with muta right away because he will have taken too much damage, and he's of course as a Protoss player you're gonna go to end the game by going to the natural instead of trying to wasting time breaking the third expansion if the muta were to stay in his base. So that's why he only built sunken from the natural because it's perfectly fine to lose your third while winning the game.
3시 정도는 딱 버려도 될 정도로.
Yeah, I mean that kind of return is worth sacking your third for. Don't you agree?
이제 상황이 너무 유리하네요.
In the situation now, if you're in an unbeatable situation.
이제는 뭐 10-12에 대한 뭐 본진 투게이트 이런 거에 대한 운영은 끝났고요. 이제 게임 좀 끝내도록 하겠습니다.
And now, you know, this is all that to say about 10-12 뭐, opener. Right now it has no real.
여기 쏠 거 아니에요. 여기 쏠 거 같으면 딱 피하면 되는 거예요. 템플.
Yeah. Now he's just saying that now 10-12 guide is over, pretty much over because there's nothing. It's way over that phase. So you're just talking about how to dodge storm. You have to do it preemptively. So when you're funneling Hydras through that little ledge in the corner of the bridge, of course the Templar is gonna storm there. So you have to split preemptively and pull back right away.
피하세요.
Just dodge the storm.
눈에 보여요, 템플러가 오는 게.
Yeah, just determine when the storm's gonna drop and your units are gonna funnel in by looking at Templar movements. And it should be easy for you to dodge the storm.
가겠습니다,
so I'm gonna shove in with one group, control group Hydra just to show you again.
못 피하겠으면은 한 부대만 가서 이렇게 템플러.
So if you feel like you're not gonna be able to dodge any of these storms like that, just shove in with one control group Hydra and just snipe the Templars first.
1.4. 템플러 1.4를 하세요. 한 부대가 죽었지만 템플러 두 개를 잘랐기 때문에
So in this case, even if one control group of Hydras died, you got two Templars, so it's a very good trade for you, because you're so ahead. Yeah. You're just trolling them, man. So Hydras are like this, they're gonna, of course, the Templar is gonna storm right there in the clump. in the middle.
쓰잖아, 봐봐. 여기에 쓰잖아. 뭉쳐 있는 데다 쓴다니까 무조건.
The Protoss will always aim at the most clumped up place. So just focus on the most clumped up place.
많아가 없네요.
Oh, he has no mana, never mind.
아니야.
Oh, no. He got stone dropped.
아니야. 상대가 안 뭉쳐 있는데 쏜다면? 그러면 뭐 내가 가서 맞아주는 건데 뭐라 할 말이 없네요.
Yeah, if the chat's just asking, what if they just storm into place, it's not clumped up, and he's like, Zero's like, wait, that means you're just walking into storm? What's the point?
아까 전에 스탑널커 따로 컨트롤 안 하시고 하시던데? 따로 컨트롤 안 했다는 게 뭔 말이에요? 드론이 죽었으면은 다시 보충해 주시고 이 판 토스가 십시비한 거야.
Yeah, if your drones died, just replenish it right away.
뭘 위해서 버티는 거지 근데 이제?
Wait, why is the girl staying in the game for? Maybe he wants to play with me for a long time.
요럴 때는 시야 확보만 잘해주시고
In this position, just spread your vision out and then just catch those zealots, stray zealots like that.
오버로드를 조금 치면 돼요.
Just spread your overlords out.
근데 딱 이거
What is this a tutorial on?
10-12 gate.
여기 이후에는 다들 관심 없잖아요.
Well, you guys don't shouldn't have any interest in this part. The tutorial's over.
Yeah. But are you telling us or is he telling?
He's telling us.
Okay.
So in this case, there's no need for you to overextend trying to shove in. Just contain the toss. That's the best method to win. It might take long, but it's the best. If you just contain him, you just win. The game just wins for you, man.
토스가 쭈르르 오잖아요? 넓게 어택다.
Oh, the Protoss is trying to bust you? Just attack, drag, click attack 10 times. Control a little bit.
상대가 빼면은 와 가가지고 리버 점사 빠방
nice.
빠방.
Yeah, and then the Protoss is retreating. Just focus fire on the important units like Reaver.
빵 템플러 점사 빠방 빵빵.
빵빵빵빵.
이제 하이브가 완성됐으면
After your hive is done, get the fire.
상대 잘한다고? 잘하지, 이 정도면은.
Yeah, the opponent's pretty good.
아, 손목 아프다.
Oh, my wrist hurts.
줄 뽑으면 다 잘하는 거라고? 자 이거 조였을 때 유닛 비율은 딱 1:1 비율로 히드라 반, 저블린 반 이렇게.
So in this case, when you're containing like this, you don't maintain a ratio of 1:1 to link to hydro ratio. What?
What?
아, 어떻게 시켜주시면 돼요?
What? Zerg link 1:1 Zerg link hydro ratio?
Yeah, count everyone.
엄마
yeah, just get half ling, half third, half hydra. Pump them up. How did it work? That was good. Yeah. Oh, it's this much army. Just. Just kill it.
그리고 저 같은 경우에는 이럴 때 오커트를 별로 안 좋아해요. 옵저버 커트하다가 병력이 많이 녹아버렸어가지고.
So in this situation like this. You know how other Zergs like to cut off the observer vision by trying to focus fire on the observer? He does not like doing that because that means you're missing out attacks with your army and then your army will melt.
전 별로 안 좋아하고
어, 사람이? 어, 네.
그냥 유닛 유닛으로 압살하는 그런 걸 좋아하거든요.
Yeah, he likes overwhelming Protoss with units that focus firing on those observers. Yeah.
Oh? 아이고 깨말본 형님 어서오세요. 어, 딱 깔끔한. GG.
That's it, man.
Nice.
Alright, get water in here.